Hey, this is Joe Price. I just wanted to point out something to watch for as you're working on the 1910 Puerto Rico hints. We're getting so close. We have, Puerto Rico now has the highest coverage of any place in the United States in the 1910 census. And so we're getting to these kind of final cases, and I just want to show you how to handle one of these. I've noticed it is pretty common in Utaro, so I just wanted to show you what these look like. So what you'll see is you'll see a person, and then you'll see that the other two people are listed as son and daughter. So let's actually take a look at the record to see what's going on. So if you look at the record, what we have is we have Carmen, and she's listed as a daughter, and she's living with Erasmo, who's listed as a son, and also with Alejandrina, who's listed as a daughter. So basically, there's no head in this household. And so what happened is basically the family search household kind of cut off the parents. So let me show you how to deal with this. So we're just going to open up the page for one of these, for the person that's already attached. So notice she's attached to the census. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to open this record up on Ancestry. And so what I did is I just clicked the search records on Ancestry, and here I can find the exact same record on Ancestry. So you can see an Angeles Utaro, and on Ancestry they actually have the family put together correctly. So what we can do then is we can come over here and add in the father. Okay, I'm going to use this kind of corrected father here. We can put that in there, and then we're going to put in the birth date and then the birthplace. Okay, so notice that we're adding in the father using the information from over here. And then notice that we get this possible match. Let's take a look at that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to open that up in a new window. Okay, so here's that person that it's pointing to. So notice that person's living here. So actually, it looks like this family might have gotten cut up into several different pieces. So then what we're going to do is we're going to add the match. So now the father's there. Let's do the same thing. Oh, okay. So I guess the reason we didn't have a spouse is because that is the only person in there. Now we can go back to this and we can refresh. And so now that we have a father, we can now put in the siblings of our original person. So we'll do that. And now we can add them. Okay. And so now we've kind of put this family back together. Now notice there's still other family members that should be part of this family. And so we can go and add them in as well. So this is a case where the family search family's been kind of split up into little pieces. The ancestry family is all still kind of in one piece. And actually, if you go to the image, you could even just look and see that it is in fact a family. So you can see there's the family. And so what we need to do in some of these cases is kind of put the family back together and then make sure each person in the family is attached to the 1910 census. Let me just try one. Let's just try one other example. See if how. Okay, so this one's not that issue, but notice here that if we look at the record, but it's kind of a similar issue where you can see here he's the male, white, he's a son, so that's the relationship to household head, but he's kind of just all by himself right here on this. Oh, I'm sorry, and then he's listed here with someone listed as wife. So my guess is that they're married to each other, but we're somehow missing the household head. So what we can do is actually come back to the image and just see what's going on, or we can go look on Ancestry. If you have a hard time kind of reading the handwriting, which is true for me. So let's see, we need Gonzalez. Man, these ones are always hard for me to read. Let's see, there he is right there. Okay, so there's our person. Notice he's listed as Jefe, and then his wife, Daniela, is listed as the wife. So it looks like maybe he just got mistranscribed. So let's go back to that record. Okay, so yeah, it does look like it got transcribed as son, even though it should have been head. So now if we go back to the census record, then we can pull his wife in, and then we're good. So I just wanted to point out that these last families that we're working on, you just might have to be a little careful about how the relationships work, and you might have to use the records on Ancestry to help you kind of put the pieces back together. But yeah, we're really grateful to have your help. And the neat thing is the reason these are so hard is because we've already done so many of the families. Like almost all the families are done, and we're down to just the last, few thousand families that we need to do. We're really grateful to have your help. on this project.